Hello everyone, welcome to another battle report for my channel. It's been a couple weeks, but we have another King's of War battle report. Battle report 32, this time we're playing Kingdom of Men versus Forces of Nature, and the scenario was loot. So before we get started, I'm bringing up this slide again. So if anyone lives in central Iowa and wants to play some games, I have some fantastic links for you here. Come play, we could always use more players, we generally play on Saturdays, etc. So finally I'm not playing dwarves for a while here. We'll go over my list quick. It is a shield wall troops. I have two of these. I have two heavy pike blocks, both in horde format. Two hordes of heavy pike blocks, there we go. One with the caterpillar item, one regiment of berserkers, one regiment of knights with brute strength. Two troops of mounted scouts, one of them has the carbine upgrade. One regiment of mounted sergeants, three siege artillery, two beasts of war with the ballista upgrades, a standard bearer mounted with the boomstick, a standard bearer on foot, a wizard mounted with bane chant and inspiring, and a wizard mounted with bane chant and the plus two lightning bolt item. So this is my normal opponent. A little bit different, but he's running two hordes of salamanders, one with brute strength, brute sharpness. He has a naiad worm rider horde. Those are the monstrous cavalry for the forces of nature, and I think they're the same in the trident realms one. Three beasts of nature. All the beasts of nature have the vicious attack upgrade thing. Two hordes of earth elementals, one with brew of haste, one with brew of courage, one tree herder with regen, two druids, and two unicorns, one unicorn with the inspiring item. So we'll go to deployment. As I said, it is loot. So from left to right, the sharks and or other guys are currently his naiad worm riders. He actually got some cool, he got those frogs from Pond Wars, frogs riding toads. So it's going to be pretty sweet when he actually gets those together. Anyway. Two beasts of war, a unicorn behind them, horde of salamanders, unicorn, druid behind them, and Wuye on the other side. He has two hordes of the earth elementals, tree herder, and another beast of war. So for my humans, apologize that they're not all painted. I'm working on it. It just takes forever to paint this many humans, especially when I had to take a break to paint all those dwarves. So anyway, right to left, mounted sergeants, boomstick, operating army standard bearer, knights, and in front of the knights are the mounted scouts with bows. Then we have a horde of pikemen they don't have anything. And in front of the, there's the, yeah, and then a shield wall in front of them, and then the berserkers next to them, and then the shield wall kind of in front of them, and then a mage between them, and then the pikes with the, with some of the guys that are painted, those are the caterpillar ones. Yeah. Caterpillar bricks. And then I have my scouts with the carbines there. And then my mage with the lightning bolt 5. My beast dwarves are a little bit being proxied here, so you can tell. So this is my tank from my dwarves, but he's on the right base. And then my last beast of war way over there, which happened to be a carnosaur on my base. And my three artillery pieces. And spoilers for anyone who's excited, but I never once land a single shot with those things this whole game. I should have done the math, but that's, yeah, they got to shoot every turn and they never once hit anything. It was pretty awful. So anyway, here's how we're lined up. You can see where the tokens are. One's on the hill, one's in the middle, and one's, there's some fences over there. So kind of got stuck in there. My plan, I guess, as far as a plan would go, would be to shoot everything off on that far side, and on this side, kind of hoping that I can win the combat. Generally, I've fought pikes and salamanders a lot, and the pikes will generally come out on top. So I'm just kind of hoping that I can win. Anyway. Turn one goes to nature, so he just moves up. He moves up, and that's about it. He doesn't have any offensive shooting, so he just surges these guys up a little bit as such. And then we go to Kingdom of the Men. So, Kingdom of the Men, I don't move around too much. yeah, just a few things move up on that side. Up here, these guys all move up pretty far. On the left, he let those mounted sergeants charge his Worm Riders, knowing that they probably wouldn't kill him, and they have some regen, so they'll be okay. But, you know, there's no reason for me not to take that charge. Otherwise, just chaffing up with my drops here. I don't necessarily like mounted scouts to chaff so much, just because they're kind of expensive. But the shield walls there, Mark, walking up in front of his salamander, sure are great. I go into my offensive shooting, and this was the ballistas off the Beasts of War actually hit and do a bit of damage here. And then I think someone's got the lightning bolt at this druid, which actually worked out well because it ended up wavering him. Over here, the mounted sergeants aren't that great, so they do what mounted sergeants do. And that's it. So that's what it looks like. Lining up pretty good. Turn two. He rolls pretty good for regen this game, so you'll see that a lot when it actually happens. So they're cool. Otherwise, all the charges you would expect, the Beasts of War come in. The Worm Riders charge, or counter charge. You can see the Salamander Hordes go into the chef as best they can, and then pick up one of the tokens. Over here, he just moves up as much as he can, and he puts his Beast of War there that's damaged behind his Tree Herder, since it's... they're both height 4, so it blocks line of sight. Healing. Yep. Healing something. I don't know what I'm showing. Combat. The Worm Riders are... Yeah, they're a lot better than the Mounted Sergeants, but he just ends up wavering them, which is pretty good for me. Not surprisingly, though, he routes the Mounted Scouts. So, that's that. Then he overruns. Not surprising, he kills this shield wall, and again, not surprising, he kills the other shield wall, and that's fine and dandy. Also, you'll notice that the picture started to get smaller here. I had before the last tournament in this game, I've been messing with the image resolution of my camera, trying to save some space, and it turns out that these image sizes are smaller than your standard slides in Keynote on OS X. So I got tired. All the other ones are stretched, like this. You can see it's stretched. All the other ones are stretched, but I got tired of stretching them. So if anybody knows how to, like, hotkey Keynote fill page with image, that would be great, because I Googled for it and I couldn't find it. But anyway, so that's what it looks like. End of nature turn two. Men turn two. Charges you expect. The knights go into the Beast of War. Pikes go in. Force Beast of Nature. I have Beast of War. Yes. My Beast of War goes into his Tree Herder. Otherwise, everyone else is just going to shoot. Shooting the... Army Standard Bearer with the Boomstick here went up to stand in front of this Beast of Nature and did a point of damage to him. Over here, I think the Ballista could see him, or there's someone over there shooting lightning bolts too. We get some Bane Chance off on the Pikeman, which is good. Bane Chance. This is kind of a blurry picture, but the knights kind of bounce. The knights are becoming my new whipping boy for this army, like the unit that just fails every time, because I can't roll dice. These pikes do okay. This was really sad. Like, so the berserkers roll, and they're hitting on threes and wounding on fours, and they do like 3 points of damage, like just whiff. And then the pikes super whiff. Oh no, here it is. Yeah, it was awful. I think one of the two did like 1 point of damage. But I rolled double sixes, so kind of made up for it and wavered them. But still, yeah. This Beast of War hits the Tree Herder and does a bit of damage. Not enough, of course, but, you know, respectable. Yeah, that's what it looks like. So we're just smashing together like we normally do. We're going to turn three. Turn three, regen. He rolls really good. This is just showing the charges you would expect. So the Worm Riders go back in to kill those mounted scouts. Um, Yep, the beasts of nature go into the appropriate things. The salamanders go back into their over here. I'm showing that salamander goes into the pikemen, and I think the other salamander goes into the berserkers because they're a little squishier, or at least they're easier to hit. That's for sure. Tree herder charges, counter charges. The only thing I didn't take a good picture of here is he does do some surge shenanigans to put that earth elemental horde into the flank of those scouts. He didn't probably have to do that, but I was like, okay, go for it. So we get a bunch of healing, like all the damage gets healed off of these guys. Super. Bane chant on these guys. Yeah, so there's the outcome of the surge. As a result of combats, of course, the Worm Riders eventually finally kill those mounted sergeants because they're not too great. The beast of nature here just wavers my army standard bearer. These guys get, this beast of nature doesn't do very much damage to these guys, so he's fine. Yep, sorry. These guys come through and smack them up pretty good, but my pikes live, and Snare is great. Sorry, I'm clicking all over today. Of course, these mounted sergeants gets routed, and that's fine. So he reforms like that. Tree herder does a few points of damage, and that's all fine and dandy. The only outcome I don't have to show here is he did charge my berserkers, and he didn't do that much damage, if I recall. So, yep. Overviews. Standard. No, he didn't charge my berserkers. I'm sorry. He was wavered, so he just sat there. Okay. Men 3. So counter charges and charges all over the board. Down at the bottom, you can see the Beast of War, aka my tank, hits those guys in the front because what else is he going to do? We're still mucking with those salamanders in the middle. Honestly, by this point in time, I thought I'd have them mopped up, but we're going in for another round. That beast of nature goes back in, or beast of war goes back into the tree herder. If anyone can follow this battle report, I'll be very impressed. Bane chance on pikes, bane chance on pikes, because otherwise they're pretty weak without it. This guy does a bit of damage, nothing special to the tree herder. This guy doesn't do near enough to preserve his own life. So he's going to die, but that's that. The knights, they do okay against this beast of nature, but I roll a 3. So, yep. Here, these pikes pick up these salamanders, which is great. They reform like this. Over here, again, the combined charge does better this time, but not enough. So those salamanders are still back. He did heal all the damage off of them, so it really has to like happen at once. So that's that overview. So currently the humans have no tokens, and the forces of nature have 2. So nature 4, the charges you would expect. I moved the army standard bearer over there to chaff up those worm riders because I knew those knights were gonna get at least a charge, if not 2 charges, and it looks like 2 charges was probably better than 3 charges. Over here, the earth elementals double charge up. They arm the beast of war, aka the tank. Tree herder and those that carnosaur are just smacking each other back and forth. Salamanders, the salamanders this time go into the berserkers. So I'm just showing that. Lots of healing. It's pretty standard. This guy always runs lots of those healing unicorns. Regens. Regening better than I can damage him. Bane chant the flanking earth elementals, because why not? Over here, not surprisingly, the worm riders pick up the army standard bearer. Reform. Over here, unfortunately, he doesn't do very much damage to my knights, but he does waver them, so that's a bummer. Over here, he does do a bit of damage to the berserkers, but he just rolls poorly on the nerve check, so they hang out. Over here, he does quite a bit of damage again to this beast of war, but he rolls really bad on the nerve check. I think he wavers him, and so he's just going to hang out. So yeah, there's nature turn four. Not a lot happening. So men turn five, I fail my headstrong roll because I'm playing. They're my knights. That's what they do. Not a lot to do over here. That beast of war there that is being represented by my tank. Oh, sorry. The tree herder must have killed that other beast of war in the last picture. I gotta get better at this thing. The tank survived, but he was wavered, so he just sits still because he's gonna die anyway. Over here, pikes and berserkers double charge the salamanders again, and otherwise the pikes flank the beast of nature, the triceratops one, and in the process we'll pick up that token. So we'll bane chain on the pikes because we really gotta get this done one of these days. I think I get a lightning bolt shot or something off on this guy, something little wavers him. So get lots of damage in on these salamanders, but yep, didn't roll it, wavered. Over here, not surprising, the flanking pikes were able to route that beast of nature, and they just kind of hang out like that. So yep, that's about it. So we're going to turn five. His salamanders back up a little bit, but just tons and tons of healing. You can see one of his unicorns charged my berserkers because they already have 10 points of damage on them, and it as long as they get the point of damage, so he'll probably pick them up. Over here, the Naiad Worm Riders charge. He must have picked up my knights last turn. Yeah. Wow. I gotta take more pictures. I apologize. Anyway. His Naiad Worm Rider charged my guys with the pikes. Yep. Not a lot else happens, just those few charges. So they route the pikes and pick up the token. These guys route the unicorn routes the berserkers, not surprising. And over here, he had triple charged this beast of war and routed him, which again wasn't surprising. So, yep, just reforms like that, turn five. So these are going pretty quick too, which is also why there's not that many images. So men turn five, the pikes go back into the salamanders, and they pick him up. Shooting, I think I hit this guy and waver him again. Yep, and that's just what it looks like after turn five. You can see I'm also chaffing up his earth elementals there too with a wizard. But so turn six nature, he doesn't really do much. Oh, he kills the chaffing wizard, but that wasn't really consequential. Yep, just moving around. I was just chaffing up this guy. It's inconsequential. So nature. So I don't actually have any pictures of men seven because nothing happened, or men six. Nothing changed. Hands. I couldn't kill anything he had that had the token. And he didn't kill my guy with the token. So, I mean, and there wasn't a turn seven. So, a little shadow there at the end, but the point being, yeah. So the results: nature had two tokens, man had one token. So it was a clear nature victory. No question about that. Thoughts in quick here that I brought three artillery pieces because you know five pluses isn't a guarantee, but you know I got 18 shots. And I didn't get a single hit, so that was just a bummer. I'm still going to keep bringing them, because I like the indirect fire rule. especially noting that most of my opponents are probably going to have something higher than height 1, and a big block of pikes is height 1, so I kind of like them. I just wish sometimes, too, also that they were, like, vicious or something like the Abyssal Taurus, but anyway. Knights are turning my whipping unit, so I'll just complain about them a lot in these videos, so if you can, maybe I'll turn out to be too negative, but that'll be something to do. Otherwise, it was a reasonably fun game. It was nice to get something other than dwarves out, that's for sure. I miss some of the stuff that dwarves can do, like golems and elementals and all that. But anyway, kind of rambling here, but thanks for watching, guys. I do probably have another report or two coming out soon, but it's been a little bit on the slow side for getting some of this stuff done, and my motivation is a little lower right now. So we'll see you next time.